Good morning, everyone. This morning I'm going to elaborate and highlight a very, very, very controversial issue among Muslims, whether to make tajiyah or not. There are two schools of thought, distinctly. One school of thought who are believer in constructing tajiyahs, the monuments. Others who believe that tajiyahs construction is inhibited, it's a haram. What I'm going to say is going to get me bouquet and the brickbats both. I'm going into a kind of philosophical angle in this controversial subject. If you look for the distance and the superfluously, you're going to say yes, that yes should not be made, this, that, and all that. Whatever the most of the mullahs and the alims and the most of the scholars of Islam have been saying. But I'm going to dwell this subject upon one phrase, and that is Al-Amalu bin Niyat. Quran says Al-Amalu bin Niyat, meaning your intent actually counts. Your intent matters. Your action does not matter. So many things we do without any kind of intention. Like lots of people go to perform Hajj, Umrah, perform even Namaz. Namaz Jummah has 300 people, but Namaz Fajr has only 3 people, Ashar again 5 people. Why this discrepancy? Meaning, most of the people going to perform Namaz Jummah, they flaunt it. They just go over there for flaunting, just show. And their intention is not to perform namaz. Their intention is to perform just a namaz to show other people that he is a namaz. Most of the Muslims go for Hajj or Umrah. They invite lots of people and lots of people will go to the railway station and they're going to say, well, guys, he is going to perform his own responsibility, his obligation to Allah. He's not actually doing any kind of favor to Allah. Why you are doing this show? Show, kiki, hee-haw. So intention is hee-haw. Intention is that everybody should kiss your hands and give you accolade and praise you, admire you, that he is haji now and this and that. I've been there for 17 times and I know what kind of people do what kind of things over there. And they come over here, they are at the Jadrasar station, they change their clothes from jeans to Lenga Jabba, and they are worried about the people who are gathering over there at the railway station. The train is 5-10 minutes late, and they were all fluttered. I'm talking about your Abdullah Bapu. He was my brother-in-law. I went over there to Rajkot to get him, and he was so nervous that he was keep asking me, Loko to chaliye nahi jaye ne? He was worried about people. He was not worried about namaz to nahi chali jaye. Now, this is what is not allowed. Now, coming back to making tajiyah. Purpose of making tajiyah is not celebrating the death. First of all, imams are not dead. Allah says in Quran that those people who have sacrificed their lives in my path, don't even call them, don't dare to call them even dead. They sacrifice their life for the promise of their maternal grandfather. They sacrifice for Islam. Like some philosophers say, Katle Hussein asl mein marge yazid hai. Katle Hussein asl mein marge yazid hai. Islam jinda hota hai har Karbala ke baad. They have actually saved Islam. Think if they would have stooped to Yazid. Nobody would have called Islam as Muhammadan faith. Everybody would have called it Yazidi faith. Allah forbid. So let them make it. They're celebrating, like say for example, parents lose their 22 years old kid in the army. They don't cry. They don't beat their chest. They don't bang their head. But they celebrate his sacrifice. And we are, come on, now how idiotic we are. that we are actually not celebrating the sacrifice of those who have given the sacrifice for Islam, for us, for the Ummat Rasul. And the second thing you remember, wherever the tajiyas are not made, Islam is gone. Karbala is gone. Imams' names are gone. Muharram is gone. I prepared 5 points. First is Al-Amalu bin Niyat. Allah says every single thing is in your intention. You come to masjid and your intention is to please me, then I am pleased. But if your intention is to flaunt, show to the people that you are namazi, don't expect anything from me. I'm going to throw your namaz back to you on your face. That is what Allah says. If you don't pay heed to your prayers, I'm not going to pay heed to your prayers. So that think the intention of those people who are making tajiyas and who are beating the drum, their intention is to celebrate the sacrifice of Imam. Sacrifice of Imam, like we do that when someone, you know, like our grandfather dies, Allah forbid, in our family, we actually invite hundreds of people to eat on Jarat, then again on Dasima, then again on Chalisa. We are not celebrating, but we are not celebrating his death, but celebrating his passing away to Allah. As Allah says, وَلَا الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَىٰ وَلَا الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَىٰ. We are happy that our grandfather has gone back to his perennial abode, posthumous abode, and he is going to meet his Allah. Point number two, celebration keeps Muharram alive and ticking. You stop celebration, nobody would know. I have experienced this thing in America for 20 years. We did not know when Muharram comes and when Igyarvi comes and when Barmi comes and when even Ramzan comes. My brother will call and tell us that today is Chandrat. You see that? If you want your tradition to wipe out, then talk turkey. Talk like stupid. Talk like those conspirators of Islam. Those opponents of Islam, conspirators of Islam. Number three, celebration keeps Muharram alive and ticking. Sorry, number three, no celebration, no Muharram in the USA, Europe, nowhere. Muharram is not celebrated anywhere because there is no tajiyah, there is no beating drum, there is no celebration. Celebration actually passes on the tradition from one generation to other generation. Muslims celebrate the sacrifice of Imam, not death. This is not the celebration of death, but celebration of sacrifice. Hanafi people, Sunnis, are going to believe that Imams are not even dead. Not dead, because Quran says that those people who have sacrificed their life in my way don't even dare to call them dead. Now, Imams who have not sacrificed themselves, who have sacrificed entire life, I mean entire family, entire brood, for their nana, for their maternal grandfather, how can we call it dead? Next, those who sacrifice their life in the path of Allah, don't even call them dead. Quran says it is conspiracy theory. Remember, Muslims, remember, wake up and smell coffee, guys. Everyone, every nation of non-Muslim population has been behind and against Islamic nation, Islamic culture, Islamic tradition. And they want to destroy every single thing by giving your wrong hadith that your prophet has said this and the prophet, and we begin to believe. Look what we have done. I give you a very live example. In my time, 07-86-92, underneath 110, Allah, Nabi, and Hajrat Ali. Then it was 783-92. 78692, and now those idiotic anti-Muslim bastards are writing 786. What about your Nabi? You stupid bastards, your Nabi was the one who taught you 786. Your Nabi was the one who gave you the name of Allah. Your Nabi was the one who gave you namaz. Your Nabi was the one who gave you the concept of Jannat. Your Nabi was the one who taught you how to perform Umrah and how to perform Hajj. Your Nabi was the one who introduced you to the house of Allah, the Kaaba. Your Nabi was the one who cried and cried in their prostration, in sajda, Ya Rabbi Habli Ummati, Ya Rabbi Habli Ummati, Ya Rabbi Habli Ummati. Hey Rab, please, you emancipate my followers. You forgive my followers. Don't put my followers in hell, in the fire of hell. And you are today, you smart bastards. You are writing just 786. Allah was there before Nabi came, but how come you did not know who was Allah? Think if you have a brain, then you think. Socrates has said, I think, so I live. And you nitwits, you don't have a brain to think, so you don't live. Thank you very much for listening. God bless everyone on this planet and give absolutely proper prudence.